Well, hello there, interwebs. I'm here today to talk to you about something very near and dear to my heart. Theater! Seriously. I know I've talked about theater pretty much this entire semester, but I figure, why stop a good thing? So, lucky you, you get to listen to me ramble for a while. I like to pretend that what I have chosen to do with my life is a little bit more important than it actually is in the grand scheme. Today, theater is not that important to most people. I'm just weird. So weird. But back in the day, theater was massive. I mean, theater helped shape religious festivals and ceremonies, the way societies interacted with each other. And our language, too. Our language. Okay. I make a big deal out of this in my paper. Did you know that something like 1,500 words, probably more than that, but like 1,500 words didn't even exist until William Shakespeare decided to invent them? Yeah. I mean, we use these words every day. It's not like made-up words like fantabulastic or flipperdo. I'm talking about words like eyeball and alligator. I mean, what the hell did they call alligators before they were called alligators? Like giant, terrifying, toothy, aquatic monsters of death? I just don't understand. Here's a list of just 15 of the words that he invented. When you use these words every day, you're technically quoting Shakespeare without even knowing it. Blushing, dawn, puking, blanket, bump, amazement, elbow, gloomy, critic, hint, label, rant, secure, swagger, torture, skim milk, unreal, lonely, lower, compromise, excitement. Actually, that was 20 words. It's really hard to pick just 15 of, like, 1,000, you know. Theater has also made a huge contribution to the education business also. Because I don't know about anybody else, but I remember in elementary school having a group of actors come to the school and do a show about bullying and, you know, how it's bad and blah, blah, blah. But, this is called outreach theater, and it's everywhere. I mean, outreach theater is used in religious groups. It's used for LGBTQ programs and everything. And on Grand Valley campus, outreach theater is used to educate the public about whatever the topic your show is about is. And on the Grand Valley campus, we have a group called REACT, which is headed up by Dr. Allison Metz, and REACT is focused on sexual harassment and, like, educating people how it can happen to anybody, what you should do if it happens to you, you know, it's things like that. And, I mean, outreach theater is huge. That's a huge part of theater. I would also like to discuss how the general view of theater has changed throughout the many, many years it's been in business. In Shakespeare's day, the Puritans preached that the theater was a place of evil, probably due to the lewdness of the shows that were produced there. And they just tried to ruin it for everyone, you know? Like, they would, you know, tell all of the actors that they were going to hell, and, you know, they were pretty much the dregs of society, and women weren't even allowed to act. They were forbidden by law to act in theater. In the 1800s, theater was very popular, and so all of societal cues like the vernacular, fashion, acceptable behaviors were all taken from the stage. Their roles in these cues were so important that an actor or actress in these times would be fined if they were caught strolling around in their everyday life without having their costume on. Today, your costume director would murder you if you were going outside the doors of the theater in your costume. You don't have no idea how much homicide would happen if she even catches you drinking a milkshake in costume. No, doesn't happen. Now, today, theater has kind of gone back to being viewed as a lower profession than compared to others. But what's interesting is that film actors garner a certain more amount of respect than stage actors do. In a perfect world, I would be performing in Wicked, Avenue Q, and Young Frankenstein the musical all at the same time. I would win 23 and a half Tonys within my career, and I would get paid $40 million per performance. But the world is not perfect, and I'm stuck facing the very real possibility that I could possibly live out of my car after I graduate from college while Snooki gets paid $30,000 an episode to get drunk and fall down. The last thing that theater affects is us, everyone. Everyone is an actor in their own way. I mean, we all have masks. Well, maybe not literal ones like this one or, you know, this one or this one. This one's this one. I'm slightly obsessed, sue me. I mean, theater affects us in ways that we don't even realize. It's all around you. All you have to do is look for it.